Hello from the Bureau, I'm climatologist Robin Dewell.
And I'm hydrologist Paul Fakema, and we're here to discuss the climate water outlook for October to December. So Robin, although we haven't seen a lot of rain so far in September, what can we expect in the following months?
Well, for rainfall, the second half of September is looking like it's going to be much wetter than the first half. And then from October to the end of the year, rainfall is likely to be above average over the eastern two-thirds of the country. This means potentially a wet end to the southern growing season in the southeast and an early start to the wet season in the north. In contrast, the outlook in Western Australia and Western Tasmania is more neutral.
What's driving such a wet outlook in the east?
Well, there's a strong indication that La Niña is developing in the Pacific Ocean. We see that classic La Niña signature of cooler than usual water in the central and eastern Pacific and warmer than usual water to the north of Australia. We're also seeing warming to the northwest of Australia in the Indian Ocean, which means a negative Indian Ocean dipole may develop as well. For Australia, with both potential for La Niña and a negative Indian Ocean dipole to warm the ocean to our north, it increases the chance of wetter than normal conditions in the eastern half of the country. It also increases the chance of widespread flooding in these regions. And this is what's expected to influence our weather till the end of the year. So Paul, with rainfall more likely, what does this mean for stream flow?
Well, if we have a quick look at the soil moisture in the top 1 metre, we can see where soil moisture is above average as a result of the recent rainfall we've had. Although some of those have dried out a little since August, the landscape in many southern regions remains relatively dry though, and we'll need to have some above average rainfall before we start to see increases in stream flows. That means that near median to low stream flows are likely at about 80% of locations for September to November. High flows are mainly expected in southeast regions where there's relatively wetter landscapes due to the previous rainfall. We are seeing some good inflows into water storages in those areas though, including in the Murray-Darling Basin where storage levels are still relatively low. So Robin, what can we expect for temperatures?
Days are likely to be warmer than average in the north and Tasmania. But for the rest of mainland Australia, the outlook is more neutral, with days even likely to be cooler than average in some regions. Nights, however, have a high chance of being warmer than average almost everywhere except southwest Western Australia.
Thanks, Robin. That's it from us for now. Please head over to our website for more information or join us for the next update at the end of the month.